Everybody is just hanging on the details of this as it comes out. And after we learned where the terror leader was hiding, it turned out that some researchers at UCLA predicted that he was right around that area just a couple of years ago. It's fascinating to me. Trace Gallagher has been looking into all this from our West Coast newsroom with this story. How did they do that, Trace?
You know, and it's fascinating, Martha, that 2 years ago we were all looking in caves for bin Laden, right? And this group at UCLA said, no, he's in a compound in a major city in Pakistan. So we're talking about Tom Gillespie. He's a geography professor at UCLA. His research partner is John Agnew and five undergrads. They took Osama bin Laden's last known location, which was Tora Bora. They used a scientific theory called distance decay, which is used to locate endangered species. It basically says that creatures stick close to what they know. They figured the further bin Laden moved away from Tora Bora, the more likely he'd find himself in an area of different religion, different politics. He's more likely then to stand out and to be discovered. Then they studied his life characteristics, right? They came up with a list of requirements. He's 6'4", so he'd need a tall building. He would need electricity to run a dialysis machine for his reported kidney disease, even though they never found a dialysis machine inside that compound. He'd need small rooms for his bodyguards and big walls for privacy. Then they used satellite images like Google Earth, and they came up with several buildings that kind of matched those requirements. And they came up with this city, Parachnar, Pakistan. It's about 30 miles from Tora Bora and only 130 miles from where bin Laden actually was in Abbottabad. The mother of one of the students was so convinced by this paper that she actually hand-delivered a copy to Leon Panetta's wife. The teacher, Gillespie, also gave a copy to the FBI in Los Angeles. It is unclear whether either one of those agencies actually followed up on this paper, but if you read through this thing, it really is fascinating on the detail they came up with and specifics.
It's an incredible story, Tracy. You know, and I wonder, you know, A, if they ever looked at that research, and B, if their own, you know, research and their own intelligence on this led them to kind of do the same kind of mapping and figuring in terms of the right kinds of places that he might be. You know, who knows if we'll ever know the answer to that, but it is fascinating.
And just to note that the FBI locally says that they won't confirm nor deny whether they ever took that paper into account. But all of this information these students used and the teachers was public information.
Yeah.
They put it in, they figured it out, and that's what they came up with. And that's a pretty close guess.
You know, it's encouraging. There's so much talk about our students falling behind, but they seem to have been doing some really interesting work on that front. Trace, thank you so much for bringing us that.
Okay.
That's a great story.
Sure.